Today we're going to show you the usage of the Rows and Columns tool in the WPS Spreadsheet. This tool can help us set the rows and columns of cells. Take this table as an example. We need to adjust the row height and column width of the current table. 1. Select All Tables. Click the Home tab and click Rows and Columns to select Auto Fit Row Height and Auto Fit Columns Width. The WPS Spreadsheet will automatically adjust the row height and column width according to the characters and numbers in the cells. 2. We can also make some precise settings. Select the target row, then click Row Height and Columns Width. Enter the required setting data in the pop-up dialog box and click OK to complete. 3. Place the mouse cursor on the row label and drag it up and down to directly change the row height of the cell. Suppose we need to insert new rows and columns in the table. Select the area with the cursor and click Insert Cell. After the dialog box pops up, we choose to insert 3 entire rows. Now WPS Spreadsheet will add 3 rows above the original cell. So how can we insert a specified number of cells? Take this table as an example. Suppose we want to add 4 blank cells at A2. At this time, select the area from A2 to D2, then click Insert Cell and select Shift Cell Right. In short, the final number of newly added cells is equal to the number of selected cells. As for those useless rows and columns, we can select the target row and column according to our needs and click Delete Cell. We also may need to hide some contents in the table due to some special needs in our daily work. Select the cell that needs to be hidden and click Hide and Unhide. After the row is hidden, the row label will no longer display the sequence number corresponding to the hidden row. If we need to unhide the cells, just click Unhide Rows. By right-clicking the cell, we can find all these features in the shortcut menu, including the Insert Cell, Delete Cell, and Hide and Unhide features that we just mentioned. Did you get it?